Rakiya lives in a small, quiet town just an hour outside of Jackson, Mississippi, with her four-year-old son, Jarandon, and her three-year-old daughter, Kaylin.
It's hard for me being a single mom, but my children are very independent to be as young as they are.
There you go. Now let's turn the water up.
Kaylin, she is sassy. She's a handful. Jarandon, he's the boss. He's the boss baby. He's the man of the house. When I found out I was pregnant with this baby, I was definitely overwhelmed. I'm hoping for the best, but I'm preparing for the worst.
The stakes are high for Rakiya because she's a Black mom in Mississippi, where maternal health outcomes are bad and infant mortality is the worst in the nation. And also because of what happened the last time she was pregnant.
I got pregnant with baby Harlem at the end of 2018, actually on Christmas. I found out, and I didn't even have morning sickness. I was like, okay, I could deal with this. You know, this is fine. This pregnancy is a breeze. It's gonna fly by.
Rakiya says her pregnancy with Harlem continued to go well until she went in for a checkup at 26 weeks.
This particular appointment, Harlem's heart rate was 169. So I said to the nurse, is that normal? Is he okay? His heart rate has never been this high. Her words to me was, oh yeah, that's fine, he's normal. I did not feel like the nurse heard me when I assured her that something is wrong. His movements had decreased. My son was always active in the womb. Always. I ended up calling my doctor, but he assured me that sometimes babies have lazy moments. The next day, I had a lot of pressure at the bottom of my stomach. I actually had to get rushed to the hospital. By this point, I'm not feeling my baby move at all. And I remember two to three doctors came in my room, and one of the doctors said, we're sorry, but he doesn't have a heartbeat. I trusted y'all with me and my baby. I basically cried out for help. I just felt like that they had let me down, because here I am now. I have a deceased baby on the inside of my womb, and I don't know why. They told me they were gonna have to do a C-section the next morning. They were just waiting on the doctor on call to come in. So all that night, I had to sleep in the hospital room with my deceased son inside my belly. Once they did the procedure, the only thing that gave me peace was it looked as if my son didn't die in pain, but I'm still grieving